Oh.
Are we going right now?
Maybe.
Okay. Hi, everybody. I'm Eric from Premier Pythons. In case you haven't seen our prior videos, the one recording Bryan, even though he says he doesn't want to be part of the videos from this wonderful company. Mm-hmm. So it's definitely his words. So I want to introduce you to a couple of our animals today, but I also just want to show you our setup. So all of this rack is an ARS 5020 rack. And if you're looking into getting into, you know, professional breeding and you really want a professional setup, you want to go Freedom Breeder or ARS. In the past, I really made the mistake of using a pretty bad rack, and I ended up losing more money on that than it was worth. So if you're looking at doing a lot of projects like we're starting off with here, definitely invest the money. 5020, you know, 50, 20, the 50 is the size, the 20 is the amount of tubs. 50 is kind of small for the bigger animals, like this girl, right, you come in and show her. Everybody. This girl, she's a little bit big for this kind of a rack. She'd be better off in the next size up, but the majority of our animals are, you know, either they're a little bit off for this rack, but all in all, this is a really perfect average size for the animals. So the project I want to introduce you to today is our clown project. So let me hop up here because I'm super short. Okay, so I'll show you guys our animals, and then I want to talk to you about what we're planning on doing with them. So we have a male visual clown, and he's usually pretty decent, but sometimes he's just really mean, so let's see what happens. But the clowns are really amazing because they've got this beautiful head patterning, they've got this amazing blushing on the sides, you see a really dark dorsal line. It almost looks like it's got kind of a spider pattern with the webbing that shoots off from the dorsal line, but it's just, clown I think is just one of my favorite patterning traits. I'm gonna put him away before he gets too angry at me. Since he's a little bit timid right now, I don't really love getting bitten. It's not horrible, but I don't wanna do it. So that's our male. And clown's a recessive trait. So the female here is a butterhead clown. And what that means is that she has a clown in her, but when I breed her to my visual male clown, I've got a 50% chance of the clown gene being visual and 50% being non-visual. So here we're looking at 50% being clowns, half of those being butter clowns, and half of them just being normal clown. And the half that's non-visual is going to be half normal head clown and half butter head clown. So we're going to have some really cool stuff, and I'm going to post a picture right now so you guys can see what a butter clown looks like, since that is sort of the ultimate snake out of that project. Something that one guy picked up a little while ago, he's not very nice, so we'll try to hold him, we'll see what happens. But he is a dragonfly head clown, and he's small, but he'll be ready to breed for next season. And I've not yet seen a dragonfly clown. I know that a lot of the firefly clowns are running in the 2000 range, but what dragonfly is he's a fire pastel pinstripe, and he's het clown. So that means that if I breed him to a female clown, again, 50% are gonna be that. Since he's got three dominant traits, it's really anyone's guess what's gonna come out, but I'm really excited for what he's gonna do. He's kind of in a bad mood today, so we'll hold him again another day, but I think he's absolutely beautiful. And he is definitely, for the potential of all these snakes, he's not the most power-packed animal I have, but considering that he has clown in him, the potential is by far higher than anything else I have. So that's sort of an introduction to our clown, to my clown project, but just for fun, I kind of want to show you some other stuff I have. So in here, and she'll be getting moved over to the rack fairly soon once she gets a little bit bigger and once I get some space, I'm moving some stuff over. Since Natalie's not able to work with a company anymore, I've got to move some animals out just to make room for the company animals. But here we have Nova, and that's just her name. It's not any kind of breed or trait or anything. I don't really know California king snakes terribly well. I won't pretend to, but I know that she's a California king snake. Beyond that, I don't really know entirely what gene. She sort of shows some resemblances to a striped, but, you know, I'm not going to pretend to know these guys as well as I know bull pythons. Usually these guys are kind of feisty, they are kind of nippy. She has never once struck at anybody. She's just really an awesome snake. She's also kind of a garbage can because she eats everything, so she'll eat four small mice every time I feed her, so she's kind of fat, like I am. Bryan, which other one did you want me to show? Was it this girl?
Yeah, I think so, yeah.
Okay, so over here, we have an Enchi Pestave pinstripe, and I just got back from out of town, so a couple of them pooped in their cage. That's nothing crazy. It's not been in there for very long, I assure you. I was at home this weekend, so I didn't really get a chance to see these guys until I just came back now. But she's an Enchi Pestave pinstripe, which means she's an Enchi Pastel Mojave pinstripe. So she's a 4-gene dominant female. And 4-gene dominant, if you mix that with other dominant traits, you get some really wild looking stuff. I mean, she's really cool by herself. I doubt it's gonna focus since it's so small, but over her eyes, she's got some really nice blue blushing, which is pretty cool. I think blue is my favorite color, so I really love that about her. But I really like her, and I'm gonna try to breed her to either my Mojave Pine or something along the clown line. I really want to mix her in with something recessive, something that's going to do some really wild stuff to the patterning, get some lack of melanin from Pied. I'll probably breed her to both gene lines down the road. But from there, I mean, she's definitely a longer-term project. She won't even be ready to breed for the next probably 2 years, but I've got some big plans for down the road that you guys will get to see. So I'll show you one other animal. She's not really she's not really a project snake per se. She's actually the first one I ever got when I started getting interested, and I absolutely love her, even though she'll get bred since she's female. It's not hard for me to pair a male with her. It's not like she's probably the least gene-packed I have. She's just a super pastel. But as you can tell, I suspect there might be some sort of low expression Enchi or something in there that's really brightening it up. If you can see in the blushing here, it's just really light, especially when you get towards your belly. You go dorsal and you start getting some reducing traits in here, especially when you get here and it actually breaks to yellow. Usually they start to fade decently, and every now and again she'll start fading, but then she sheds and she just brightens up like crazy, and the head stamp is super, super pronounced. So I'm really not entirely convinced she's just super pastel. The breeder I got her from, Seth Custer, is really amazing, and he will actually undername the traits in snakes as opposed to trying to fit more stuff in there. So that's why I really suspect there's something else to her. But yeah, I mean, she's the first one I ever got, and I'm just really happy with her. So if you guys have any questions about ball python care, any of our projects, just let me know. But we've got a number of other projects I'm really excited to show you. I just wanted to show you the one project and start introducing a couple of my pets, just since I love it so much. So if you guys have any questions, let me know. Let me know what you think in the comments below, and make sure to like and subscribe. Yeah.